I bet you all are wondering, where the hell is this thing? Where did it go? Where are all these exotic armor pieces? First, the way you do it, the way you get these helmets is by going to the Cosmodrome and doing this little guy right here, Legend Lost Sector, and you can see that the rewards say exotic head armor rare and enhancement cores. And next to the exotic head armor it says if solo, so that means you have to solo this legendary Lost Sector, basically the same as when Season of Warmind was out. So first you're going to want to drop in at the steps on Cosmodrome, and then you can go ahead and mark this. Now if this does not appear on your screen, that means that you are not high enough level to do it. So you have to be at least 1205, I think, to be able to see this on your map. So make sure you are that level. Now what you're going to do is you're going to want to go all the way back here, and you just kind of follow this area. So once you get over here, you just sparrow your way all the way down to the end, and here is your Lost Sector, which is way in the back near this watchtower or this water tower, and it's called the Exodus Garden 2A. So basically the only thing you're gonna have to worry about is the Fallen Champions Barrier Overload, and obviously it seems kind of difficult considering this is a high level mission and you can't afford to put two primaries on. So in order to actually be able to do this, you're going to need a power bonus plus 6. And that is because you get enough unlocks to be able to get thermal overload, which is important for disrupting overload shields. So I'm going to go in an in-depth view of exactly what I'm running and my build. So first, if you're a hunter, you should be gunslinger, use swarm grenades, triple jump, gambler's dodge, or marksman dodge, doesn't matter, but I'd say gambler's dodge because there are some faraway enemies. And then use bottom tree gunslinger for the extra damage. And you're also going to pair that with Celestial Nighthawk. So moving on to the weapons, we're going to need Witherhoard, which will be great for sticking enemies and keeping them low, and also taking out a large variety of enemies in an area. The Catalyst is recommended. It helps you be more efficient in taking out the champions. Next we have Ikelos SMG. This would be the ideal role for you. You'd want Threat Detector and Disruption Break. Disruption Break because when you break barrier shields on champions, they actually are more susceptible to kinetic damage, which makes the Witherhoard stronger. I would also recommend putting a boss spec on that as well. Moving on, we have the Falling Guillotine. Doesn't really matter what role, although this one would be the best one. Throw a boss spec on it, and that's going to be used for taking out servitors and other yellow bar enemies pretty quickly. Now for armor, you're going to want to have grenade launcher ammo finder and global reach. This ensures that you'll be able to kill a lot of enemies when you destroy your warmind cells, and thus making it easier to clear adds. Optimize for discipline on all your armor. So next, for your gauntlets, you're going to want your anti-barrier mod for SMG and fastball so that you're able to accurately stun overload champions. And then you're going to have cellular suppression on, which is a warmind cell mod from 2 seasons ago, which makes it so that when you shoot warmind cells, they release a blinding nade effect, and it affects a lot of enemies around you when paired with global reach. Next, for your chest plate, you're going to want grenade launcher reserves to make sure you have Witherhoard ammo. You're going to want melee damage resistance because it resists damage when you're sorting enemies up close. For your boots, you're going to want any sort of picking up orbs of light mod, preferably innervation on a solar armor, because then you'll be able to get your grenades more often. Grenade launcher scavenger helps you maintain that Witherhoard ammo. And then lastly, on your cloak, you're going to want Surge Eater, which recharges your grenade ability whenever you stun overload champions with your grenade. And then Thermal Overload stuns overload champions. And then Global Reach, which helps with your Warmind Cell build. As soon as you get in, you're going to want to go straight for the servitor. Make sure you take him out fast, and then take out this shank just a little bit. Make sure you take out those guys. and then go ahead and take out these shanks right here, because they will be protected by the barrier champion that comes out later. Again, stay up in this tunnel right here. This tunnel helps you maintain a good safe distance and coverage from all the enemies. And as you can see, I shot one Witherhoard and it just completely annihilated everything. And if you guys have seen Error's video, you can see that I dropped a Warmind cell from doing that, even though I didn't kill anything with Ikelos SMG. And that is because I had my Witherhoard procced, and then I pulled out my Ikelos and it counted as kills. And it has a chance to drop a Sand Seraph cell. Anyways, since there's Scorched Earth modifier, they're going to be throwing a ton of nades that do a lot of damage. So just make sure all these dregs are dead. You're going to want to make sure they're gone. And then here's where it gets a little difficult. You're going to want to damage this servitor enough so that his barrier comes up. And then you're going to want to knock it with your SMG. And then take out the shanks. And that helps it so that you can easily make work of this champion without having to deal with all those shanks, because they are very hard to deal with, and they do a lot of damage if you're trying to take care of your champions. So then once you have that, you just go ahead and finish off your champion. And then the next room opens up. So once you get over here, you want to stay behind cover, and once you have your nade, you want to bait him out. And once you have him baited out, you just go completely after him, either finish him or get him low enough and kill him. So now you just want to go ahead and take out all these guys. If you get killed, it's all right, don't worry about it, you'll be able to get your revives back. You just want to be able to make sure you can kill everything. You can definitely play it safe. My first time running this, I actually did it flawlessly because I did not know that you could actually use the revives. So if you can just play it safe, that's perfectly fine. That'd be great for you. Just make sure you don't get any snipers. Do note that I am also a 1205 plus. I'm 1214 now, and that really helps me be able to take out these adds, you know, with these. And I actually recommend a Ikelos SMG, because when you hit these enemies right here, you can see that they start staggering severely. There's some sort of weird unstoppable glitch that happens, and none of the enemies will be able to attack you. So once you've killed all those adds, you're going to want to throw down a Witherhoard right here and start damaging. Overload Captain, and there's also a barrier over there, and you're going to want to throw Witherhoards here because there are enemies that come down like this, and you want to be prepared for them because they will in fact kill you. So once you have that down, you just want to make sure you keep throwing Witherhoards down and stay up here and slowly pick off all these adds. Once you do that, you want to pop Celestial Nighthawk, hit that man in the head. See, I'm doing a ton more damage with Witherhoard, about 1,000 more damage. So it's absolutely nuts. And yeah, so there's a lot of adds, and you're gonna just have to take care of them for a while here before you can really go after the champions. Kind of a mess, but it'll be alright. And you have enough time, just trust me, because after this room is the boss room. You just want to keep getting him weak. I get the shield again, you just knock it back down. There we go. Now we got our revives back. Just shoot that once. Make sure you blind everything. And then make sure you don't get hit too much by that guy. Okay, once he's dead, it's easy from here. You're just going to want to take out all these adds that are over here. It will be easy to take them out. You're just going to need a little bit of time. But you do have enough time from now. Do not fret at your time limit, because this boss is very easy. Witherhoard makes quick work. so I would not worry about it. There's fire Witherhoards back there. As you can see, he's already getting pretty weak. And you can probably just Celestial finish him off. You're just gonna wanna go for that chest. And boom. There's the finish. Now you can leave. And that's how you complete the Legend Lost Sector and kill all the champions within the time limit. And at the end, you should be awarded Mask of Bakris. It might be rare, might not. It took me my first try, but you do have to solo. And here's the proof, just so you guys know that I actually got it. I'm not trying to troll you with this video. I want you guys to actually get it because it is very fun exotic. So, that's that. Thanks for watching.